Now, aside from Trump's wrath, Google is facing more legal woes. 36 states, including New York, California, and Utah, and the District of Columbia, are suing the tech giant over claims its app store abuses its market power. The case challenges the search giant's plan to force all app developers who use its Play Store to pay a 30% commission on sales of digital goods or services. The change is set to take effect in September. The suit is the latest in a series of major antitrust cases filed against Google, but it's the first to challenge Google's control in the mobile app store market. Former U.S. President Donald Trump is taking on big tech. He's suing Facebook, Twitter, and Alphabet over their suspension of his accounts following the Capitol attack in January. Trump said he filed the lawsuits in federal court in Florida, alleging the tech giants of censorship.
We're demanding an end to the shadow banning, a stop to the silencing, and a stop to the blacklisting, banishing, and canceling that you know so well. Our case will prove this censorship is unlawful, it's unconstitutional, and it's completely un-American. We all know that. We all know that very, very well. It will be a pivotal battle in the defense of the First Amendment, and in the end, I am confident that we will achieve a historic victory for American freedom, and at the same time, freedom of speech.
Trump was kicked out of social media platforms this year for violating their policies against violence. That's after a mob of supporters attacked the Capitol following his repeated false claims of election fraud. Twitter banned Trump permanently, while Facebook has suspended him for 2 years. President Duterte signs an executive order institutionalizing the Financial Stability Coordination Committee, rather Council, or FSCC. FSCC is an interagency body which aims to strengthen the Philippine financial system by mitigating risks through policy frameworks. It will be headed by the governor of the Philippine Central Bank. Now, other members will include the finance secretary, insurance commissioner, Philippine Deposit Insurance Corporation president, and Securities and Exchange Commission chairman. The agency also has the power to coordinate with foreign regulators.